as a Black woman with a criminal record, who's not a rocket scientist, not an engineer, nor an astronomer, I had to ask myself, do I belong in space? Before I got my contracting job at NASA, I wasn't one of those kids that dreamed of the stars. I was just trying to find my way on this planet. Navigating Earth is hard enough. Why should I be concerned about space? I have enough problems here that I need to be focused on, like getting and keeping a job, putting food on the table, taking care of my family and responsibilities right here, right now. So space was never in the cards for me. It wasn't until I was exposed to space and the possibilities, after having worked at a space organization for almost a decade, that I could even begin to answer that question. And now, I'm on a quest to bring my people with me. Because yes, we do belong in space. It's not just for billionaires like we think, even though the people that look like us aren't really represented. You don't have to be a rocket scientist or have an engineering degree or even be record free. Shocking, I know. In fact, not only do we belong in space, but we are more connected to it than we even know. Don't believe me? Watch this. Raise your hand if you think you've ever used the technology that's come from space. You've touched space at least 10 times before you walked out of your house and probably didn't even know it. That bed you slept in, if it's a memory foam mattress, that's a space technology. Those memory foam pillows you laid your head down on, those sneakers you laced up, yep, all a result of space exploration. Now, raise your hand if you've ever used a camera to help you back up in your car or park. What about to take a selfie? Ever had an X-ray at the dentist? What about you're shopping and you hit that self-checkout? Yep, again, all considered technology from space. You see, space isn't just for us. It's all around us, embedded into our daily lives, our very being. We're in space right now because guess what? Earth is a planet in space. And our being is made up of matter, which makes up the universe, which includes space. But let me get back to my story. Being in proximity to information changed the way I viewed things, especially when it came to space. I learned about pioneers like Katherine Johnson, an actual human computer whose calculations got us to space. Hal Walker, the Black man that shot the laser to the moon so we could know its distance from Earth. George Carruthers, the Black man who put the first world observatory on the moon. And Benjamin Banneker, one of the first Black US astronomers. But it didn't start there. For centuries, our people's genius has been used to advance the world with the use of the stars, from farming to navigating the seas to even building the pyramids. So today, I'm gonna talk to you about space and people's proximity to Black genius. But first, let's level set. Proximity is the state of being near in space or time. And in this instance, we're applying proximity to social and economic implications. So now that we're on the same page, let me tell you a story. Long ago, when our policies in this country weren't what they are today, a man of melanated skin wrote a letter. And in that letter, he addressed a rather disturbing perspective and narrative that the Secretary of State at that time had shared. In short, part of that messaging created the narrative that Black people were not as smart as non-melanated people. Well, my friends, the lie detector determined that was a lie. The man in question and the Secretary of State at that time was Thomas Jefferson. But it wasn't about the lie. It really was about the exposure or proximity Thomas Jefferson had to the genius of Black people. The stories he was told and the narratives that were shared, these are what shaped his perspective and therefore caused harm. Over time, politicians would create laws and policies that would rob the world of seeing innovations attributed to people who did not look like them. And if they did, they were destroyed, literally and figuratively. Tulsa Massacre, the Wilmington Massacre, and countless other Black towns. During those times, curiosity could get you killed, and so Black genius became hidden. Yet innovations and genius weren't uncommon in a Black community. But if it was left up to Thomas Jefferson, and if it wasn't for the heroics of Benjamin Banneker, that is what people would believe. You see, the power is always in the narrative, the stories we tell ourselves from the experiences we have. And those experiences are highly influenced by our environments and what we are in close proximity to. So back to Benjamin's letter. Benjamin Banneker, a profound and self-taught astronomer, scientist, and inventor, through his genius, published an almanac where he would post about his predictions and his readings of solar eclipses and the stars. He would then use this almanac to prove Thomas Jefferson's narrative wrong and even get him to advocate in the support of the intellect of Black people. And this, ladies and gentlemen, became the first example at space being used to bridge the proximity gap, proving that the innovations and diverse experiences of Black people are contributions that the world needs and can rely on. Now let's ponder. What if there was only one lens that the world was viewed through? What if all of the innovations and creations by Black people did not exist? What if we kept our genius, our curiosity hidden? Maybe this is a better question. What does the world look like without the current technology we use today? No phone, no GPS, no x-rays, no FaceTime, no cameras when you need to back up in your car when you want to take your selfies. That means no TikTok, no social media. Now, what if I told you that we could thank the excessive need for us to explore space for most of our favorite things? And that most of the things that we love are a result of our curiosity and our proximity to genius. Would you think you belonged in space? Well, with the new space economy, we have a chance to get it right, to unearth our curiosity, to take us into the next industrial revolution with Black genius at the helm. You don't have to be building rockets or launching satellites to work in space. You don't have to work for anybody, actually. Space startups are a thing. I would know. I have one. It's called the Equity Space Alliance, and we're making space equitable. I'm taking my genius and putting a space lens around it, because guess what? I do belong in space. Everything that we have here on Earth, we will need in space. Things like plumbing, like brewing coffee or growing food, or beauty products that we use every single day, even photographers and graphic designers. There's even room for creatives. So what's your genius? How can you take your genius and apply a space lens to it with what you're doing? What can you think about that we have here on Earth that we will need in space? There are 1.3 trillion reasons why you should try. That's the actual projected value of the space economy in the next 7 years. $1.3 trillion. Don't you think your curiosity is worth a piece of that? Especially when, according to Prosperity Now, Black median wealth is projected to be zero by 2053. That's still in our lifetime. So I'm challenging you. Will you join me in changing the trajectory of our wealth? Because like I said, we do belong in space. Our Black genius belongs in space, even if their proximity to it seems too far away. Thank you.